Hey everyone. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at how to install Cisco Modeling Labs, or CML, on Proxmox. With the recent changes earlier this year around availability of free VMware ESX, I'm seeing a lot more interest in people potentially looking at alternatives, including Proxmox. I've been running Proxmox in my home lab for a couple of months now, running a lot of different home lab systems, and one of the things that I do use regularly for my job is Cisco Modeling Labs. Now, while CML isn't officially supported by Cisco running on Proxmox, it does actually run quite well with just a couple of minor modifications during setup and install. So of course, this video will demonstrate just what I've found works for me in getting this installed and set up and working. However, should there ever be a point where Cisco does decide to support CML on other platforms, the official guide and instructions may differ from what I show in this video. So with that said, let's go ahead and get started. So I'm running Proxmox version 8.13 in my lab right now. I have three separate nodes in my Proxmox cluster, which all have enough resources to run CML. So we'll go ahead and up into the upper right corner and click Create VM. I'll select node VM02, since the resource utilization on that node is a little bit lower than the others. Then I'll give the VM a name, which is CML. We'll hit Next, and we'll select where our installation ISO image is. For me, it's on a network storage, so I'll go ahead and select that storage here and drop down to the CML 2.6 ISO. We'll go ahead and click Next. On the system page, we will have a couple of changes. The first change that we'll make on the screen is modifying the BIOS from the default to the OVMF or UEFI BIOS. Then we'll have the option to select where we want our EFI storage to be. In this case, I'll go ahead and store it with the VM, which I'll be installing on an NFS share. Now, for my day-to-day VM, I do run this on local NVMe storage. However, for the purpose of this video, I'll just go ahead and install it on my NFS share since I have more storage availability there. Once we're done here, we'll click the Next screen and go over to Disks. Now, the default is 32 gig, which is plenty to run a couple of labs. However, if you need more storage, feel free to adjust the size here. I'll go ahead and increase mine to 50 gigabit. Next, under Advanced, we'll need to select the Async I/O from the default to native. On the CPU tab, we'll give the minimum of 4 cores that are required to run CML, and we'll change the type to Host. This will allow it to run nested virtualization, which allows us to run our different network container VMs. On the Memory tab, we're able to throw as much memory as we'd like at our CML VM. In my case, I'll go ahead and put 32 gigs on the VM for now, and we can always adjust later if we need to. On the Network tab, I will disable the firewall, and for my home lab, I'll set the VLAN tag to 2. Once we're done with that, the initial setup wizard is done. However, we'll need to go find the VM to make one more change before we can start it. So I'll expand VM02, go down and find VM number 125 for CML. Then under the Hardware section, we'll add a new CD or DVD drive. Again, I'll select my NFS share where I keep all of my ISO images, and we'll select the RefPlat ISO that comes with CML. This contains all of the network device images that we'll use within CML. Once this is all done, we can go ahead and start this VM and begin the installation process. Now I will run through this installation process pretty quick here, but for those of you who have installed CML before, there's no differences from here on out for the installation process, so you can carry on as you normally would. So once the virtual machine finally boots up, we'll be given a blue screen with the CML logo. We'll go ahead and hit continue, accept the agreement, navigate through a couple of different interface screens that provide us some help. I'm gonna go ahead and name my CML system, just CML. Next, we get to configure our system admin user. Now, if you're not familiar with Cisco Modeling Labs, this is not the user that you'll be using to log into the system to build lab topologies. Instead, this is the backend Linux system user that you can use to log into the system administration UI for doing things like software upgrades or shutting down or rebooting the system. Now, by default, this user is named sysadmin. For convenience, I usually just rename this to admin, and I'll go ahead and configure it my username and password here. On the next screen, we will be asked to configure our regular system user for CML. Now, this user is the one that you will use to log into the web UI to configure network topologies and labs. Again, by default, this one is named admin, and for convenience, I've named both the system admin and the normal admin users the same thing. However, you may wish to keep these separate if you like. Next, we can configure networking. By default, it is on DHCP. However, I'll change mine to static and configure a static IP address, netmask, gateway, and a local DNS server. Next, CML will need to begin copying all of the network device images from the reference platform ISO file. This process can take quite some time, so we'll come back in just a second. Once all of those images have been copied into the CML VM, our system is ready for us to go ahead and log into and start using. Once this is all done, we'll get a little warning saying that the system is now done and ready to use, followed by it'll drop us off to the normal Linux shell, showing us the addresses that we can use to log into our CML system. So I'll go ahead and drop into the web UI here real quick and log in with the admin user that we created. And now we have our CML dashboard where we can begin creating labs and building topologies. Okay, I think that's it for this video. I hope that this was helpful, and thank you so much for watching.